Hey everyone, welcome to ApogeeEdge 4-Minute Videos for Developers Season 24. In this series, we are going to discuss about API security using OAuth 2.0. In the first episode, we are going to discuss about why do you need OAuth 2.0 when you are securing your APIs and exposing it to the outside world. I'm sure day in and day out, you are actually accessing APIs which are secured using OAuth 2.0 when you are interacting with various applications. If you are logged in using sign in with Google option or sign in with some other identity provider option into any third-party application, that means you have access to APIs which are secured by OAuth 2.0. Let's understand why do you need API security like OAuth 2.0 when you are exposing APIs to the outside world. Let's say you have a backend system and various data sets are stored in this backend system in different databases. This information is exposed using various services, which are nothing but APIs, which does various operations like updating the data, creating the data, deleting the data. In general, most of these services are kept inside the firewalls of enterprise systems. Because of the security complications, because of maintaining and exposing this data to the outside world, typically these kind of services are secured using either basic auth, which is a simple legacy way of securing the APIs, or most of the times these enterprises do not have any security at all, and that these are kept inside the firewalls. Only a limited number of people can access this information. But today it's all about bringing new players into your ecosystem and exposing this data to various other parties. Let's say you have different kind of stakeholders, like your partners, like third party people who wants access to this data, or maybe third-party applications who wants to integrate with your business and consume these services as an APIs, or maybe internal systems which are designed for specific purpose which needs access only to some set of services. The legacy authentication mechanisms like basic auth you cannot leverage in these scenarios because of three reasons. The first one is authorization and giving limited access to different set of resources. You cannot share the passwords with different people or different applications directly. Doing so will give access to the entire set of resources that are there in your backend systems. So if you want to give limited access, then username and passwords are not scalable. At the same time, let's say you want to give for a limited time and you want to revoke the access after a certain point of time, then you cannot give access using username and passwords. And it's not easy to change them when there are multiple people involved while accessing these resources. Let's take an example. Let's say you are a big bank and you have various services like transferring the funds, or getting the account statements, or getting the account information, or getting the profile of the customer. So you have various services stored and the data stored inside your enterprise. Let's say there is a third party who is giving you the credit score and user wants to give access to only the statements where the third party can read the transactions. The user cannot share the username and password with this third party. Doing so, what will happen is the third party can misuse this information and do the fund transfers to some fraudulent accounts. So you cannot give the access to your information by just giving away the username and password. You need to selectively give access to selective resources or the data sets to selective people. So how do you do that? Let's say you want to give limited access. Let's say you want to give access at the limited time and you want to revoke at a later point of time. So username and passwords are not scalable and it's not easy to share this information across different set of people. That's where OAuth 2.0 comes into the picture. You need to implement OAuth 2.0 for your services and APIs to give access to various third-party applications or different stakeholders at different interval of times. ApogeeEdge acts like a OAuth 2.0 authorization server where you can able to secure even your legacy APIs and new kind of APIs using OAuth 2.0 in ApogeeEdge platform. We're going to see how we're going to do that and how Apogee can help you hands-on in future videos. Thank you for watching this video. Please share this video with your friends and colleagues and subscribe to our YouTube channel.